The fireman
boy.
This is the story of Benjamin. He lives in ancient Egypt at the time of the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti.
I like to live here. Here is very, very beautiful, he said.
His father, Luke, has a small factory. He makes gold tables and chairs. Benjamin helps him. He is a fire boy. Every day he pushes a long handle up and down. The work is hot and very hard. But what can he and his father do? They are poor people. They need to make money. Every evening they sit beside the Nile. Luke talks to his son about the factory, tomorrow's work, everything. One day we're going to be very rich, he tells Benjamin. Are we? The fire boy looks into his father's tired eyes. Yes. Luke smiles. I don't know how and I don't know when, but we are. Then he stands up. Come on, he says. It's late. Let's go home. 3 days later, Benjamin and Luke are making a table. It is very hot in the room. Suddenly, Luke stops work. What is it, father? Benjamin asks. Is something wrong? I don't know, Luke answers. He closes his eyes. It's my head. I can't. And then he falls on the ground. Father. Benjamin runs to Luke and puts one hand under his head. Father, are you all right? The next day, Luke stays in bed. I'm sorry, Benjamin, he says. I want to work, but I can't. I'm ill. Benjamin is very sad. Father works too hard, he thinks. That's why he's ill. We need more money, but what can I do? Then he has an idea. Of course. He thinks. I must make something for somebody very rich. Somebody like the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti. Luke is ill for 2 weeks. In that time, Benjamin makes a lot of tables and chairs. But not only tables and chairs. He makes a gold necklace, too. There. He thinks late one night. It's ready. He smiles. The necklace is very beautiful. The queen of ancient Egypt. Nefertiti is going to like this, Benjamin thinks. She's going to pay a lot of money for it, too. I know she is. The next morning, he goes to Nefertiti's palace. The necklace is in a bag under his shirt. What do you want? Asks a palace guard. There are two guards. Each one has a sword. I want to see the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, Benjamin answers. Both guards laugh. Go home, boy, says one of them. The queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti. Nefertiti doesn't see people like you. Benjamin is very unhappy. What do I do now? He thinks. He leaves the palace and begins to walk home. But 10 minutes later, he passes two men in the market. Nefertiti's women are coming here tomorrow morning, says one. They're arriving very early. They want to buy lots of new clothes for her. That's very good news, Benjamin thinks. The next day, the fire boy gets up very early. He makes a cup of sweet tea for Luke. Then he goes to the market. I can give the necklace to Nefertiti's women, he thinks. They can give it to the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti. For me. He waits and waits. For a long time nothing happens. Then music starts to play. A moment later Benjamin sees a long line of people. They are coming from the palace. Four men are carrying a very beautiful chair. A woman is sitting in it. Benjamin puts one hand across his eyes. It's the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, dot. He thinks. She's coming, too. A minute later Nefertiti arrives. Suddenly everyone is very quiet. Then Benjamin thinks, this is the moment. He runs in front of Nefertiti's chair. Stop. He says. Please. Stop. The queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, looks at him. What do you want? She asks. Benjamin gives her the necklace. Is this really your work? Asks Nefertiti. Yes, yes it is, Benjamin answers. Guards, says Nefertiti. Give this boy some money. She holds the necklace in her hands. This is beautiful. She says. Then she leaves. Benjamin runs home. He is very, very happy. Luke is in bed. Look. Benjamin says. He shows the money from Nefertiti's necklace to his father. But how? Luke closes his eyes, then opens them again. I don't understand, he says. Benjamin smiles. He sits down and tells his father everything. At the end of the story, Luke says, "You're a good son, Benjamin." Thank you. That night, Benjamin looks up at the stars. Now I can pay for a doctor to visit father, he thinks. Then, after father is strong again. But at that moment he stops. One of Nefertiti's guards is standing in front of him. He has a big sword. Are you Benjamin, son of Luke? He asks. Benjamin looks at him. Yes. Yes, I am, he answers. Come with me, says the guard. The queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti. Nefertiti likes your work. She wants to give you a job at the palace. But I have a job, Benjamin says. I work with my father. I can't leave him. You don't understand. No. You don't understand, the guard says. When the queen of ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, gives you a job, you take it. He puts one hand on his sword. Now go and say goodbye to your father. At the palace, Nefertiti talks to Benjamin. She is wearing his necklace. I want you to live here and make lots of beautiful things for me, she says. Thank you, the Queen of Ancient Egypt, Nefertiti. Of the Nile, Benjamin says. But, the Queen of Ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, looks at Benjamin. But, I can't live here. You see, my father is very ill and, Benjamin tells the Queen of Ancient Egypt, Nefertiti, everything. At the end of Benjamin's story, Nefertiti looks at him. All right, she says. You can go home to your father. But, asks Benjamin. But from today, the two of you work only for me. Do you understand? Oh, yes. Benjamin smiles. He is very happy. Now he and his father can make lots of beautiful things and be rich. Yes, I understand.